And now we're gonna do something everybody like to do. All right, here we go. One, two. One, two, three, four.
Yo, 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 this is Charlie Toner from Jurassic 5.
This is Mark Ray.
This is Craig Charles.
And you are now tuned into Joints and Jams.
With Shaka Loves You.
With Shaka Loves You.
With Shaka Loves You on Soho Radio. Listen on the sly.
You gotta have tiny legs.
Nah, longer fingers, I think.
I can ruin any party, mate.
Just say no. and
good luck on y'all show, man, for real.
Welcome back, wherever you are. As always, we are Shaka Loves You, and you're tuned into Joints and Jams here on Soho Radio.
Yeah, so we've got loads of great music coming up for you in the show today. We've got new tracks from Sly Fifth Ave, Prince Fatty, and our good friends The Allergies, a track off their new album.
And we'll also be joined on the phone later on by another couple of legends in the scene. That's going to be the Nextmen, so make sure you stick around for that.
And don't forget, if you like any of the music we hear on today's show, we've made handy Spotify and YouTube playlists of loads of our favourite joints and jams, so you can go and check those out at your leisure. So keep it locked into Soho Radio today. We're starting the show with the legendary Herbie Hancock and the track Doing It.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Brad from the Nextmen, and you're listening to Shaka Loves You on Soho Radio, and this is Joints and Jams.
The prayer in the sun, the fall in the night, Carta Brasileira dancing into the daylight. Te swing e rebolado, don't know how but I try to. Seu jeitinho, your carinho, something that I'd fly to. Quer saber de onde só? Brasileira, meu amor, Brasil. Quer saber de onde só? Brasileira, meu amor, Brasil.
Jungle you like an anaconda. Just the way you are, make it much better. When you're the years gone up on the mind center.
Kicked off the show there with Herbie Hancock and Doing It. We then went into The Knocks and a track called Brazilian Soul. That's featuring Sophie Tucker. And the last one you heard there was Prince Fatty and Shanice McMenamin. Take Me As I Am, that's featuring Horseman. How's it going, man?
Yeah, not too bad today. I had a bit of a late night last night because I decided to stay up and watch a live stream that was on Canadian time. So it started at like 1 in the morning UK time, so with our mates the Funk Hunters, shout out Nick and Dunks.
That's right.
So they were doing, yeah, because we're going to be guesting on their live stream in a couple of weeks time, so I wanted to tune in and just get a little bit of a vibe for the show, but obviously it meant staying up till like 3:30 in the morning, which I'm completely not used to now that we don't have any gigs.
Ha! Yeah, no, I can't stay up past I think 11 o'clock is pretty much my cut-off time.
Usually I'm not, yeah, pretty much the same these days. But. Yeah, so you were away on holiday last week, were you not?
Yeah, it was my turn for a staycation this time. Although, is it a staycation? Because I don't technically live on the island. I mean, you went to Skye and you're from there, so...
Yeah, I suppose. So, just a holiday, really. Just a vacation.
A vacation, yeah. To the Isle of Mull.
Yeah, we're keeping it local these days.
Keeping it local. To be honest, it's like I feel like I'm going to be an advert for Calmac Ferries, but I mean, it was £20 to get the ferry from Oban. Beautiful place, amazing time. Yep. Really, really nice.
Nice.
And got to see the fam, got to see the family as well, which was really good. First time I've been up the road. And I did say to my mum, stupidly, do you need any help around the place? And she made me paint the shed out the back and pull the most amount of ivy I've ever seen in a shed down.
Well, we came round and just stopped in briefly to see your mum, and she was the bonnet of her van was up and you had your head fully in it. You were doing like repairs on her van when we came round.
Yeah, totally. Got to earn my keep. Well, that's enough chat from us. Here's one from the Pointer Sisters. This is How Long.
Bitch. Oh, heaven, you sound like a bird.
So those last three for you were The Pointer Sisters with the track How Long. We then went into Shuggy Otis and Inspiration Information. And then we finished off those trio of tracks with The Visioneers and their cover of The Far Side's Running. Up next, we've got a new joint from Sly Fifth Ave. The track's called Let Me Ride, and it's featuring Jametta Rose.
Shucks on mic. Come on, brothers. Hit me back. One time.
Ouch!
All right. Out of sight.
Till the break of dawn. Till the break of dawn.
But I
all, because within these pages there is something for us all. And I am not professional, but I love basketball. The squeaking of a sneakers, the echo in the hall. But if I don't have enemies, I'm not doing my job. I might throw out a curveball, but I never throw a lob. And people criticize me, but I know it's not the end. I try to kick the truth, not just to make friends. But hey, diddle diddle to the people in the middle. We got hot wax and it's cooking on the griddle. Got the guitars drumming, the drama drumming. The people are humming and the rappers loving. But hey, diddle diddle to the people in the middle. We got hot wax and it's cooking on the griddle. Got the guitars drumming, the drama drumming. The people are humming and the rappers loving. A sucker, even though I'm stuck on you. Each one should teach one and share with one another. So many is out there that's living on the cover. Your mother, your father, your sister, your brother, your friends and their enemies all have their lovers. People in the middle, we got hot wax and it's cooking on the griddle. Got the guitars to rumming, the drama to rumming. The people are humming and the vibes was bumping. Hey, diddle diddle to the people in the middle. We got hot wax and it's cooking on the griddle. Got the guitars to rumming, the drama to rumming. The people are humming and the vibes was bumping. Of a sellout, cast your first stone, but then get the hell out. The people say they know me, I can tell you that they don't. The people say they own me, I can tell you that they won't. The left and the right, they all try to use me. But I'll be in the places before they can abuse me. So roll down your window and listen what I'm saying. Relax your mind and let the band keep playing. To the people in the middle, we got hot wax and it's cooking on the griddle. Got the guitars to rumming, the drama to rumming. The people are humming and the vibe was loving. But hey, diddle diddle to the people in the middle, we got hot wax and it's cooking on the griddle. Got the guitars to rumming, the drama to rumming. The people are humming and the vibe was loving.
Helping you to make up your mind. have to say it again. Jesus is waiting. Yeah. Talking about you've got a friend.
Last three you heard were Sly, Fifth Avenue and Let Me Ride. We then went into Michael Franti's Spearhead, and that's People in the Middle. And then we finished up with Jesus is Waiting from Al Green. Up next, Sampa the Great and Freedom.
I'm searching for my home.
So thanks for tuning in. If you've just joined us, you're listening to Joints and Jams on Soho Radio, and we are Shaka Loves You. So don't forget, we've got a chat with the legendary Nextmen coming up in the show later on, so stick around for that. So those last three you heard were Sampa the Great and the track Freedom. We then went into an edit of ours by Banda Black Rio, and the track is called Expresso Madureira, I think.
That's another Latin one that you always seem to have to read it.
I always get the Latin ones.
See, what happens is when you send me the track list, I cunningly look at where it sits in the order of who's yeah. going to be saying it, and I'm like, I'll go first this time, Jamie. I'll start.
Yeah. And then we finished up those three with our good friends the Allergies and their track Every Trick in the Book off their brand new album Say the Word, which you can go and check out now. I finally got some time to check out just last week. I kind of slept on it for a little while because it's been out for 2-3 weeks, but yeah, great album, loads of great tracks in it, loads of great collaborations on it as well. Those boys just keep churning out absolute quality tunes, so go and check it out. The Allergies, Say the Word, out now.
I think we may have the Allergies coming on the show pretty soon, I think.
Yeah, they're going to be our guests next month.
If all goes to plan.
Yeah. Up next, we've got a brand new track, which I heard on one of Scratch Bastard's live streams. Track's by Branko, the artist Branko. I think he's Belgian, I think. And the track's called SDDS.
text my ex. Woke up in the morning, heard the voicemail, she was vexed. I swear, sometimes, man, it feels like I'm the hex. But I keep on busting out this bulletproof vest. Got kicked out of the cab cause I was sick. Drove the driver madder than a hatter with my lip. I missed my mum's birthday, I did it in the worst way. Cause I was getting high and had me wick. Oh, man.
Gonna made a fool of myself.
Another dice, another chance to hit a double six or pay the price. I wanna be the man with all the baddest moves. Turns out I'm just the man with all the bad advice. So it's not nice, but it's okay. I'm still standing for another day. Like the other night in Camden, I linked up with a random. But now I've got 18 years of bills to pay.
Those last three you heard there were Branco and SDDS. We then went into the new Master Sounds and Tantalus, and we finished up with the Nextmen and Gentlemen's Dub Club with the track Done It Again. That's featuring Kiko Bun. And that brings us nicely into our chat with the Nextmen. We caught up with those guys a few nights ago and basically talked about all things music and the Nextmen. If you've not heard of the Nextmen before, these guys have been prolific remixers since 2000, so we're going back about 20 years. You know, they've worked with Public Enemy, The Far Side, Blackalicious, Jeru the Damager, Groove Armada, Fat Freddy's Drop. Their DJ sets are renowned the world over, popular at big festivals such as Glastonbury, Teen the Park, Festival, V Festival. If you can think of a festival, these guys have played it. So here it is, our chat with the Nextmen.
So we're joined by the legendary Nextmen, Dom and Brad. How are we doing?
How you doing, guys?
Jazzy Jeff certified legendary now.
Yep, that's how we must be referred to, as the legendary Nextmen. No
one. Yeah, totally. All market material. So, speaking of Jazzy Jeff and Stream Raiders, you're fresh off of Stream Raiders from last night.
I mean, it's a very interesting format. Obviously, it's new. 15 minutes each with two rounds is an interesting way to do it. And for the viewers, if they manage to keep up with it, if they jump on the train at the beginning and manage to stay with it, which is most of them, then I'm sure it's a lot of fun for them. And we've got smoother at the transitions and stuff like that, because you can imagine behind the scenes, there's an awful lot of phone calls and texting. Yeah,
everyone's on WhatsApp, like, you ready?
we set up a WhatsApp group on the day earlier on and make sure everyone's okay, and then we paste in the correct raid commands into the WhatsApp.
Right, so you can't get it wrong then.
So that people have to copy and paste it and can't get it wrong.
Right. But yeah, that's it's been, I think like A-Skills has been the first one to kind of like sort of brand it up like that, you know, like doing the raids. And yeah, it's been for the viewers, it's been pretty cool, I think.
It's interesting that it's, you know, yet another Twitch feature, gamer feature, that turns out to be perfect for DJs.
Yeah, totally.
You know, it's really good. That platform for what we do, all of us, is a lot better than the others because of the community features and things like raiding, because it's a bit like being at a festival and seeing a lineup on a stage, and you don't have to go anywhere, or you can all go somewhere else.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah. So yeah, maybe want to talk a bit more about live streaming in a sec, but just how's lockdown been for you guys in general? Obviously, we're kind of a bit more out of lockdown now, but what's your thoughts on everything? And
go on, Brad.
So my wife's been shielding because she's got quite severe asthma. So until recently, she hadn't left the house for more than 100 days.
Wow.
And we've got three kids. And that part of it's been difficult. Sort of homeschooling. And then slowly each one of my children going back to school for a little while before the summer holidays. I've got two kids that are moving schools. My eldest, who's 14, is going to Brit School in September, which is like a performing arts school in South London, and he's moving from his school in North London. So I've had all that kind of to negotiate and sort out. And that's been really boring. And in terms of like not DJing.
Yeah.
It's just been really weird.
Yeah.
Well, no, me and Dom have been doing it for more than 20 years together. So every weekend, obviously, we'll be out somewhere doing something. Yeah. And just for that to just stop is very strange.
Was there anything that you've kind of like picked up that you kind of always wanted to do over lockdown that you were just never had the time to do before lockdown?
No, I mean, I haven't had the time, mate. I've got three children.
Yeah, totally. That's a fair point.
I guess we've learned how to use OBS.
Yeah.
And set up lights in our studio and do green screening and all this kind of stuff. The skills that you never thought you'd get, you know, you would achieve. But what about you, Dom? Anything? Learned anything new?
No, I think there have been... I mean, I've got two children, two young daughters. And because I worked from home a lot anyway, some things didn't actually change much.
Yeah.
Like I was with kids a lot. And then regarding homeschooling, I tried it for, I think we tried about a week and it just turned into this disaster. Every morning with the girls just sort of, at first they thought it was funny setting up the front room like a school. And then the novelty wore off, and because they don't have the same respect for their mother and father that they do
for the teachers, totally.
It very, very rapidly descended into, oh, shut up. So I kind of resorted to some general knowledge.
Yeah.
But yeah, there have been positives. I mean, in terms of curating music, which we all have to do much more intensely now, because you know, when you're playing, if you're touring a DJ set around a release, or even not around a release, you can tend to do a similar set, say in each six cities in the UK, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And you can go off piece and vary it. But with live streaming weekly, you have to find new stuff.
Yeah, totally.
I mean, my record collection, not vinyl, I haven't really touched the vinyl yet, but in terms of Serato, is now so organized and there's so much new stuff in it. It's like we were talking about, Jamie. You can end up locked with your Shazam to someone's stream.
Like, totally.
I was doing that last night.
You know, and then the next day I go through it and I try and find them. Some are quite hard to find.
Yeah.
And then if you can't find it, you mess it, you whisper the DJ and say, can you give me that?
Yeah. We were chatting, again, going back to Z-Trip, kind of asked him a similar question about, what are the positives that have come out of it for you? And he said the music thing. I think pretty much everyone has said that, you know, from a DJing point of view, like finding new music and like it's pushed you to have to dig like way harder than you would normally. But also he was saying about like the connections that have kind of come out of this, like straight away, like you guys is an obvious one for us, you know, like we were obviously like fully aware of you guys and, but we didn't have that, like we didn't have that same connection. And so that's been...
That's totally true. I mean, we're all talking all the time now, aren't we?
Yeah.
I mean, we've been fairly close on and off with Yoda for quite a long time. He kind of semi-A&R'd an album
right.
we did.
Yeah, because he used to work in A&R, because we had him on the show as well, and he was talking about yeah. back in the day.
We did it with him.
Yeah, so we did an album on Antidote, didn't we? Did we end up?
Yeah. Yeah. But this was supposed to be the future.
Yeah, is that actually on Antidote? I think it is. Or at least...
Yeah, it is.
At least Blood and Fire and Piece of the Pie are. I think the album is. I'd have to look.
Yeah. I remember we had a meeting with everyone and he was there, but... You know, we've known him a long time. We've known all of those guys a long time.
Yeah.
But now we talk regularly.
Yeah.
About all sorts of things. Because kind of, it's like we talk to you. You know, we're all helping each other out, really. That's what we're doing.
Totally.
The trick here is for us to stay buoyant, isn't it? So that we're
yeah.
still, you know, doing our thing while we can't do our
yeah,
thing.
It's very easy yeah. to kind of just disappear off the face of the earth if you're not, you know, yeah. when the live stream thing came in, everyone's like, right, I better get on this, otherwise, you know, what are you kind of yeah. posting, what are you doing, you know?
Yeah.
I've also never listened to as many DJs yeah. play as I have.
Totally.
I realise that I never used to really, like, you'd hear someone if you're on a bill with them and occasionally mixes, and but like in terms of just watching DJs yeah. and what they do,
you were so geographically limited before, unless you were literally at the same festival yeah. or same lineup as somebody, like you yeah. couldn't. And okay, people might do like pre-recorded stuff, but in terms of like live shit, you know, you can tune into Jeff every week at the moment, or you know, whoever it is,
yeah. every day,
yeah, 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 totally.
And it's quite good for your discipline as a DJ or a selector as well, because it's so revealing. You know, on a big loud sound system, something's going amiss, you get the levels totally. A bit wrong, that doesn't matter. But with this, everyone's right next to you, aren't yeah. they, really? They might be further away than they used to be, but they're actually a lot closer.
Yeah. yeah.
And they can see everything you do and any mistake you make, and you know, you tidy up your stuff.
Yeah. yeah. Yeah, you're way more under the microscope now.
I think yeah. the support that everyone gives each other in the chat rooms as well is like phenomenal, the way that everyone's just banded together. And you don't normally get that unless like you're at a gig with your mates or hanging backstage with other DJs and that. It's such a nice thing to have happen out of all this.
No, it is. It's funny when, you know, we had Kiko last night and he wasn't aware of the ins and outs of live streaming and Twitch and stuff like that. And so we gave him a really quick lesson.
Yeah.
But look, it's all about that chat room and we make it really big on the screen.
Yeah.
And it's all about that. That's your crowd. When you ask for flames.
Yeah,
chat,
yeah, yeah, yeah. I saw that, yeah.
You're saying say ho to the
yeah,
crowd.
Everyone.
Yeah.
It's the same thing, but online.
Yeah. And it was something, I think it was like a DJ City podcast. I caught a little snippet of it yesterday. And he was saying that like, one thing that I can't remember who it was, the DJ that was on, but he was saying that the amount of messages that he's got, not just to people saying, oh, I'm loving your music, whatever, but saying, like, you know, you've properly helped me out through lockdown.
Yeah.
And, like, you know, shit like that is, like, you wouldn't get that, you know, you wouldn't get people coming up to you after a club set, you know, saying that kind of stuff. But, like, obviously it's different because of the, you know, the global situation, but that's been another, like, you know, it's a nice little positive yeah. to come out of it for the DJs.
Totally. It's just mad to see the geographic kind of split of all the people that are checking out the streams, and suddenly you've got, oh god, you're in Colombia,
yeah,
you're in Saudi Arabia, you're in Andorra. It's just like so weird to yeah. think of these people are doing that in their back gardens or in their kitchens and all these different places. It's really yeah. cool.
I've really enjoyed that. You know, we're supposed to do 7 till 9 on a Friday, and often whoever's going second does carry on a bit.
Yeah,
and about 1:30, 2 in the morning the other week. And what I enjoyed about that is at the beginning we had our regulars
mm-hmm.
in the chat room. There's probably 25 people that are pretty chatty.
Yeah, yeah.
And then some other people which are lurking but still regulars. But by 1 in the morning, I had a completely different group of people.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And they were just as chatty, but they didn't have any idea who I was.
Yeah, so they're just like landing on your page from...
Well, there were more questions.
Right.
And say, oh, this is cool, you know, and it's just simply because of the time zone.
I am totally, yeah.
That's it.
It's simply because of that. But that's I realized at that point that doing these long sets that actually cover a few time zones is a really good way of engaging and getting traffic.
Yeah. Yeah. So, shall we take it back for a bit? and chat about kind of a bit more Nextmen based stuff. So you guys, you both grew up in Cambridge.
Yeah.
What was the Cambridge scene growing up like?
So, as teenagers and into hip hop, we had a very, very good record shop.
Oh yeah.
Called Jay's. And it was as good as any of the shops in London, really.
They also ran a mail order company, Assassin Records. It was like the biggest hip hop mail order company in Europe.
Wow.
So what were they called?
Assassin Records.
Oh, okay, right.
And so it was going in there and all the and because the people that ran the shop weren't really interested in hip hop, they used to leave all the promos out so you could go and get. Well, it was that kind of era when sort of Beatnuts records and Diamond D records were coming out and you know, earlier Tribe Called Quest records. They'd have all the American promos that you could just buy. And if you were quick enough, you could nip in there on a Tuesday, I think it was, and get them all.
Nice.
Yeah.
And so there were lots and lots of DJs growing up, really, that were all playing hip-hop. But some quite good ones, weren't there, in Cambridge, Dom?
Some really good ones. And again, though, it's all because of that shop. If that wasn't there, I don't think it would have happened.
No, it was all based around that shop and access to that music.
So you guys both play instruments as well, right? Was that kind of came first before like the DJ side of things? Because Dom, you play guitar, right? And Brad, you play keys. Was that how you kind of like met, like through that?
We met at sixth form. How did we meet? Oh, you tried to sell me. He tried to sell me a bag of magic mushrooms.
What was it? Were they fake ones or something?
I asked Dom if he'd do some scratching on a record that I was doing, like one of the first tunes I did, and he sort of looked down his nose at me and went, you know, no.
I don't remember it.
But it wasn't really till. Because you went to university in Glasgow, didn't you, Dom?
Did you?
Oh, yeah, we had a chat about this on the phone. Yeah, I completely forgot about this.
Oh, man.
Yeah, I did animal biology.
That's right.
And it wasn't until after Dom came back from uni that I got asked to do the London Posse remix, didn't I? And I didn't know anyone that had equipment. And right. I knew Dom had a EMU sampler and a Mac, and I asked him if he wanted to do it. And we did it together, and then that got played on the radio, and that's how the kind of
music so the two of you started then from there.
But we sort of knew about each other, obviously, from sixth form, and I wasn't DJing at the time. Dom was DJing from a very young. You were what, 16 when you started DJing, were you, Dom?
I was 14 when I started, and it was because basically what happened is I wanted to get two turntables, and my dad had a brilliant record collection. A lot of 70s funk.
Nice.
Yeah.
And so we'd listen to that all the time, and I'd go through all this wall of records he had. And then there was a guy that lived on my road in Cambridge called Nicholas, and he used to go over to New York and bring back very early hip-hop records. And he told me about what you need to do, and you need to have two turntables, and then you mix the stuff together. So one day, me and my dad rescued this turntable from a skip that was outside the house, pretty much. And we brought it into the house to try and wire it up so I could have two to work with. His one and this one we'd found in a bin. And it gave him a massive electric shock. This huge electric shock, and so he left me to it. And then there was all sorts of wiring problems and stuff. But I managed to get it to a point where I could mix two records together. And then it just kind of went from there.
Amazing. Am I hearing this right? Both of your dads are in a band called The Previous Men. Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so they're both musicians. You know, my dad's a guitarist, Brad's dad's a keys player.
Well, there you go. That's where you picked it up from then, I guess, eh?
Yeah. they did a few gigs. I remember my dad showing me the artwork for a Previous Men gig, and he's like, it looked like a kind of old plaque on the wall of a pub, and he goes, look, I've made it really retro. they were playing in a pub or something. Yeah, but they met probably only 10-15 years ago at a party in Cambridge, didn't they?
And then became best mates.
And then became best mates. Amazing. Yeah, my dad's no longer with us, unfortunately. But he, it was good. They it's good that they became mates and yeah, they played a lot. Especially when my dad was sick. Dom's dad would go around to my dad's house and play with him in his back room in his little studio, and they'd play together.
Well,
and
that was a really nice thing that
ended up happening out of all that stuff.
That is nice, man.
Yeah.
So fast forward a bit, you're talking about working together. What's your kind of current setup for working on music together? Do you try and do as much stuff as you can together, or do you kind of?
It's usually, if you listen to any Nextmen record, usually one of us did the bulk of it.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
The other is involved in a kind of finishing and finessing stage, and then there's a few, interestingly, like Blood and Fire and Piece of the Pie, which are probably the best, which we actually did completely together.
Okay. And do you find it difficult working together, or do you find you work better?
Things are much easier now, don't they?
Like us.
Yeah.
Well, I think it's the same with any duo. You just got to find the way that you're most productive.
Yeah.
If you're in the room together all the time and that isn't productive, and when you've both got kids and other commitments, sharing things and just adding bits and taking bits away is a really productive way of working. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we found that as well. We kind of originally started off doing kind of everything together, and then we're like, right, well, why don't we play a bit more to like our...
For most duos, though.
Yeah, and it takes a bit of time to find that out.
Mm-hmm.
Took us way too long.
We're still going fairly strong, I suppose. You know, we've had lulls in our output.
Yeah.
You know, there's been times we look back at and think we just should have been more active then.
Mm.
But think the ship's pretty steady at the moment, so there's some good stuff coming. We're actually kind of quite far into doing a drum and bass record now.
Right. Oh, nice.
A full album.
Yeah.
Wow.
And we've been working with some really good people. We've kind of recruited jungle and drum and bass producers to come and help, because if you're going to step into that world, you need to have.
Yeah, you want to have that level of like.
And stuff. Yeah. So Harry Bryson from Polar and Bryson, I've been working with him, and Brad's been working a lot with Selector J-Man from Bristol.
Right, nice.
We're sitting on a pile of tracks, actually. Kiko's across it. Who else have we got on the vocals, Brad?
Eva Lazarus, Kiko, Gardner, Joe Duke, in fact, Freddie Scott.
Nice.
J-Man from Bristol, Shumba Youth, this guy, Johnny from Gentleman's Dog Club. Bunch of people.
Sounded pretty good, isn't it?
Holly Cook.
Yeah, it's kind of good.
And have you got like a time frame for that, or is it just still?
We're trying to find it. We want to find it a home. I mean, the thing is, it's a label would be good. If we can get the right deal, a label would be good. But it's going to come out. So even if we don't find the right place for it, we'll do it ourselves.
Yeah. Nice. Right. Amazing. Well, it's been a pleasure to chat to you both. We'll see you at the weekend. Have a great stream tonight. Guys.
Yeah, wicked.
So massive thanks to Dom and Brad for taking some time out of their day to chat to us. Don't forget, we will be releasing the full-length video interview that we recorded with those guys next week, next Wednesday, on our Facebook and YouTube channel, so keep an eye out for that. So as usual, we're going to play out the remainder of the show with some of our favourite joints and jams at the moment. And don't forget, if you like any of the music you hear on the show today, we've got a handy Spotify playlist where we collate loads of the music that we put into this show. So don't forget to head over to Spotify or YouTube to check out those playlists.
From east to west, north to south, the station of now. Soho Radio. Wish to be bad like Bobby. Been there, done that. Smashed her. Rockin' rhymes is my hobby. You're probably like, was he on? Cause I rock it from the start till the beat is gone. Not in the mafia, but I'm the microphone don. And the words that I shoot out my mouth for Teflon. Jeru, never touch your microphone wrecker. Leave out in the stretcher. Step up in my sector. Try to match wits, but the mental will crush ya. Jeru, the damager, the sun toucher. Peace. Here, how to slow it down.
it out. You ain't gonna never understand it till you've been all down in it.
Girl, I wanna make sweet love to you.
a nigga like the lip. For no reason at all, I can't recall cause niggas rolling C's in my face. Down the hall, I'm kicking it in the back of the school eating chicken at 3. Wondering why's everybody always picking on me. I tried to talk and tell them, chill, I did nothing to deserve this. But when it didn't work, I wasn't scared, just real nervous and unprepared to deal with scrapping, no doubt. My pappy never told me how to knock a nigga out. But now in 95, I'm a survivor, a man on my own. Fuck around with fat lip, yeah, shit get blown. I'm not trying to show no macho is shown, but when it's on, then it's on.
Can't keep running away. Up on his own, can't depend on friends to help you in a squeeze. Please, they got problems of their own. Therefore, they count on seven chicken shits. Don't get to heaven till they face these fears and these fear zones. Used to get jacked back up in high school. I played it cool just so some real shit won't get full blown. Being where I'm from, they let the smoke come quicker than an evil redneck can lynch a helpless color figure. And as a victim, I am feeling low key. Till the keyhole itself got lower than me. So I stood up and let my free form for free. Said, I'm gonna get some before they knock it out me. I don't sweat it. I let the bullshit blow in the breeze. In other words, just a breeze. Yeah.
Bye.
shook it at the party lights. If you've never shook it before, you got to shake it tonight. Don't let this train of thought leave you behind. We're not going to a place, we're going to a state of mind. Talking about love, that's the thing that I've been speaking of.
Thanks again for tuning in. We are coming to the end of another show. Remember, if you want to hear any of the music that we played today, you can head over to Spotify or YouTube and just search for Joints and Jams. And please don't forget, head over to shakalovesyou.com and sign up for our monthly mail list. We'll be sending you a free track every single month, and you'll also get discounts on our Bandcamp and our store.
So thanks again for tuning in. We've been Shaka Loves You. You've been listening to Joints and Jams on Soho Radio. We'll catch you next month.